In this lesson, we will talk a little bit more about fetch, pull, and push. So we've covered these actions in the toolbar lesson, and I'll quickly review the fetch and push actions before going into the default settings for pull. So fetch is available from this drop-down menu, this pull drop-down menu, and you can set the default for any of these actions just by clicking on the radio button here. If you're unsure which default setting to use, pull fast forward if possible is the default setting when you download GitKraken Client for the first time. So when in doubt, you can use that as a default setting. If you only wish to fetch, then you can set that as your default setting, and that will rename the pull action item, action button in the toolbar to fetch. So I can click on fetch and it downloads the changes to my local repo, but does not merge them into my repo. Okay, and then push will push whichever branch you currently have checked out to whichever remote you have set as the upstream. If you have questions about how to set upstreams for your local repos, check out the set upstream lesson, which should be grouped together with this video as well. Okay, but really what we need to look at are these three other options that are available. So you can choose to set fetch as a default in that pull drop-down menu, but you have three other options. You can pull fast forward if possible, pull fast forward only, and pull rebase. For the most part, if you are, you know, creating feature branches and then merging them into dev, you may not find yourself seeing much distinction between at least these two options here, pull fast forward if possible and pull fast forward only. Where you may start to see these start to matter is if you have two branches, so these should be named to main, but they'll still do the job here. If you have branches where your main branch has commits, here we go, this is the image I want to use. So you have a branch locally with commits and your remote also has additional commits that are not on the other branch. So that's where these other options start to matter. So pull fast forward if possible. First, let's briefly review that pull is technically two actions at once. You're doing a git fetch, which downloads the changes from your remote, and then a git merge, which then merges those changes into your local repository. So when you do a pull, you're actually merging those changes from your remote into your local repo. So pull fast forward if possible. It will perform the fetch, but it does a check. It will check to see if a fast forward is possible. And fast forward will just mean, oh, okay, I can just advance. I can replay the commits that I missed. And here I am. I am back at the latest commit from the remote. And so if that's possible, it will perform the fast forward. If it's not possible, it will perform a merge. So this does a really good example of demonstrating. So this is a pull. Pull fast forward if possible. If it's not able to fast forward because you have commits that don't exist on the other branch, then it'll perform a merge. So that's what pull fast forward if possible means. It'll try to fast forward, but if it cannot, it will perform a merge. Again, you may not run into that scenario if you don't have two branches that are getting commits at the same time. If your feature branch, for example, is the only one getting commits, then you might not even see those merges happen. Pull fast forward only is very similar to pull fast forward if possible. The only difference is that after it performs a fetch, if it sees that it is not possible to fast forward, it will not perform a merge. So it will not make any changes. So all it does is fetch, but it does not merge those changes into your repository. And then pull rebase is handy if you wish to have a pretty clean looking commit history. So pull rebase will take any commits and replay them onto the branch. So let me see if I have a good example here. So yeah, so in this previous example where I had remote commit one and remote commit two on the primary branch and I had these other three commits, those three commits were replayed onto the main branch. So they were rebased. So that's what the pull rebase option does. Again, when in doubt, pull fast forward if possible is the default pull action. You can set it by clicking this drop-down menu in GitKraken Client and set it as the default. And I also recommend checking out our documentation on our Help Center if you wish to kind of go through the same examples and read more closely what these do. For the most part though, if you're someone who is, if you don't expect commits to be happening at the same time that you're making commits, if the branch you're merging into isn't going to get any commits that you might miss from your feature branch, you may not need to worry about the distinctions between these three. But if you are someone who has that scenario, hopefully this video helps you understand the subtleties between pull fast forward if possible, pull fast forward only, and pull rebase.